UFOs help save England during World War I. I bet you've never heard that before, but not only am I not crazy, this story is fully documented. Let's turn the clock back to April 24th, 1912. It's 2 years before World War I. The Imperial German Navy has just announced its intention to build a fleet of Zeppelins for its military. These were the pioneering early days of aviation. Airplanes were lightweight and underpowered. They didn't even carry weapons. But Germany had Zeppelins. These were huge airships powered by multiple diesel engines and able to reach the then almost incredible speed of 50 miles per hour. They could carry thousands of pounds of bombs into the air. Zeppelins were a game-changing technology, and while the Royal Navy's dominance of the seas had kept Great Britain safe for hundreds of years, its skies were wide open. It was only on May 13, 1912, that the Royal Flying Corps was formed. It was a good first step, but building a national air defense wasn't easy, nor quick. In fact, it would take years. Pilots had to be trained. Aircraft had to be designed and built, airfields constructed. There weren't even proper anti-aircraft guns at the time. However, it quickly became apparent that Britain didn't have years. On June 8th, news reached London that two Italian dirigibles had dropped bombs and routed a Turkish cavalry unit during the Battle of Zanzur near Tripoli. Air power was suddenly, well, powerful. Any illusion that London couldn't be reached by air was shattered just a month later, when on August 10th, a British civilian pilot named Frank McLean flew his plane up the River Thames. Arriving over the city, he flew between the upper and lower spans of Tower Bridge, and then flew under London Bridge. Except for some bobbies blowing their whistles, there was nothing to stop him. Then, just a month later on September 19th, news came that the German Zeppelin Hansa flew from Germany to Sweden. While passing over Copenhagen, it overflew the Royal Navy's newest battlecruiser, HMS Lion, which was at anchor in the harbor. Rather than demonstrating England's naval superiority, all eyes looked skyward. The British had been upstaged by Germany. Then, in October 1912, there were two more serious developments. First, a Bulgarian airplane bombed the city of Adrianople, causing a city-wide panic. Second, on October 12th, Germany took formal delivery of its first military Zeppelin. Z1, as it was called, was 518 feet in length and could carry 8,000 pounds of bombs to high altitude. It was untouchable, able to fly well above the reach of any airplane and far out of range of any gunfire from the ground. Just 2 days later, during the evening of October 14th, England had its first sighting. An oblong craft was spotted just off the coast at Sheerness. This was a Royal Navy base 40 miles to the southeast of London. Then, a month later in November, a cigar-shaped craft was spotted over the Firth of Forth, all the way up in Edinburgh, Scotland. Could the Germans really fly the full length of the North Sea? Panic spread in Parliament. Immediate action was demanded. This was a national emergency. But the sightings didn't end. In fact, there were more to come. On January 4, 1913, there was a reported sighting at Dover on England's south coast. Then, on January 8th, an oblong-shaped craft was seen off of Ireland's west coast near Newport in County Mayo. What followed was a rash of sightings across all of England, Scotland, and Ireland. During the last week of January and the first week of February, there were over 225 sightings. One cigar-shaped craft even flew up the Bristol Channel in broad daylight, as witnessed by thousands. Parliament ordered a massive mobilization of funds and personnel. Military pilot training increased, high-flying airplanes were designed, anti-aircraft artillery units were formed, new anti-aircraft guns were also designed, and work began on how to mount machine guns on airplanes. The greatest breakthrough of all was the invention of the Buckingham incendiary bullet. As a result, when the Great War broke out in 1914, the British were nearly ready. The German Zeppelins did attack. Over 50 raids were flown, leaving 1,413 dead and 3,409 injured. It could have been far worse, though. By 1916, the Zeppelin threat to London finally came to an end. Those early efforts had paid off. Britain's air defenses had finally grown strong enough, and thousands of lives were saved as a result. All of this story makes perfect sense, too, except that, well, it doesn't. It turns out that prior to the beginning of the war, the Germans never flew a single Zeppelin flight over England, and certainly not over Scotland or Ireland either. In fact, the first military Zeppelin, Z-1, didn't fly until the 13th or 14th of October 1912. When it was supposedly spotted off of Sheerness, it was actually on a ferry flight from Friedrichshafen, in Bavaria, to Johannisthal, near Berlin. In other words, it was nowhere near England. The cigar-shaped craft spotted at Edinburgh wasn't Z-1 either. The Zeppelin had a maximum round-trip range of just 450 miles. It could never have reached that far north, nor to Dover as reported on January 4th. And it certainly couldn't have reached Ireland on January 8th. As for the 225 sightings in late January and early February of 1913, none of those could have been Z-1 either. In fact, when the Great War broke out in 1914, Germany's Zeppelin crews complained that they hadn't ever flown over England at all, yet they were expected to find London, in the dark, and bomb it. So if it wasn't Zeppelins, what was it? Well, most of the sightings came at night. The objects were usually cigar-shaped. Sometimes they shined lights down onto the ground. Sometimes they made noise, and yet other times they were silent. They moved unpredictably, hovered in place, changed direction seemingly at will. Then they would suddenly dart off at high speed and disappear into the distance. To the modern ear, all this sounds familiar. What the UK experienced in 1912 and 1913 was a rash of UFO sightings. Yes, unidentified flying objects, nowadays called unidentified aerial phenomena, or UAPs. On the other hand, it could have been a case of mass hysteria, though personally, I think there's little doubt that people were seeing something. But what? Regardless, those hundreds of supposed Zeppelin sightings in 1912 and 1913 caused Great Britain to declare a national emergency and invest heavily into its first air defenses. That effort began fully 2 years earlier than it probably would have otherwise. Therefore, it isn't stretching it to say that UFOs can be credited with saving thousands of English lives during World War I. In the truest sense, those sightings were unidentified, they were flying, and they were objects, the very definition of UFOs. Of course, I'm not saying it's aliens. You know, maybe it was weather balloons. I'd be inclined to believe that too, except that the UK didn't have weather balloons in 1912 or 1913. Only the Germans did. I'm Thomas Van Hare, and this is Historic Wings. Please subscribe and click like. And remember, there's always more to the story.